The first day of school. There's nothing quite like it. A week before my alarm goes off, outfit ready to go, a new backpack in the corner of my room, and a new set of shoes outside. I jump out of bed to take a quick shower. Wait, what time is it? 7:05? Oh, I got time. Innocent say I keep a check. She was a bad bag, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, you're a wreck. Needless to say, I'm keeping a check. She was a bad bag, nevertheless. Calling it quits now, baby, I'm a wreck. Crash at my place, baby, you're a wreck. Digging in a bad way, losing your grip. Screaming at my face, baby, don't trip. Someone took a big L, don't know how that felt. Looking at you sideways, party on tilt. Certain things you just can't refuse. She wanna ride me like a cruise. And I'm not trying to lose.
Oh shit, I'm late.
Then you're left in the dust. Unless I stop by you. You're a sunflower. I think your love would be too much. Or you'd be left in the dust. Unless I stop by. Made it. Wait, why am I on a school bus? I'm in college.
I like no blueberries in my ice cream cake. No air to breathe with that masking tape. Stop me. I need a hostage free, I need a rocket ship, I need a run from. I like no blueberries in my ice cream cake. No air to breathe with that masking tape.
Stop me, I need a hostage free, I need a rocket ship, I need a run.
Good morning, we are up bright and early for our first day of class. Not really, it's like 11 a.m. But today is my last first day of classes ever. Aaron and I are headed to an English class right now. Honestly, it feels kind of weird going to class right now. I haven't been to a classroom on this campus in, I would say, probably a year. But first, Aaron and I are gonna go get some Dunkin' for breakfast, as we always do. I only have two classes today, both of which are with Aaron. Our classes are in person this semester, which is weird because I feel like I've been doing online classes for so long now. Aaron, this is your last first day of school ever. You will never have a first day of school again in your life, in your entire life.
Damn.
Aaron's like, I don't care. You remember going to first day of school as a kid? You hadn't seen your friends in an entire summer because you couldn't see them over break. You make new friends.
Those
There's that
days.
Cute girl in the class. No, just me. Alright, so Aaron and I just finished our first class, and then we spent a little bit of time taking a look at whether we could take a better class. Not because of the class we took is so bad, but the first week of classes, it is so essential to pick good classes. You know, if you pick a good class that's fun with friends and a good professor, you're gonna have a great semester. And then if you pick a bad class, you could have a terrible semester. I'm speaking from experience. So yeah, I'm pretty happy with the schedule that I have right now. I also ordered some textbooks, which I have to pick up later. And then I think we're gonna get lunch now. We should go that way. Okay, we're gonna go eat and then go to one more class. Just two classes today. Light work. All right, Aaron and I finished up lunch. We're headed to our second and last class of the day. The weather has gotten a little bit gloomier. It just started to rain right now. I mean, literally right now. Ow, it's in my eyes. But yeah, even though it's raining, it's actually pretty warm here in Nashville, which is a nice change of pace from New York, where I couldn't step outside without my hands freezing off. All right, last class, we can do this. This is my last class of my last first day of school. All right, it's 3 p.m. We're done with class now. I have to go pick up some packages right now because I got some stuff over break, but then obviously I wasn't here to pick it up. So we will grab some packages and trek back to the dorm in the rain.
Have a good one.
Have a good one. So warm here in Nashville. All right, got a few packages. Thank you, by the way, to everyone who sends me stuff for mealtime. I read every letter, open every package, most of it actually on camera. Hey, Elliot, I hope you're having a great day. I've been watching your channel for over a year now, and even though I technically have never met you in real life, you have made a pretty big impact on me. On the side, I like to make stickers, so I thought I would send you some. Darren, thank you for your note, and thank you for the stickers. What? Is this a Squirtle waterbender? This is a Pikachu airbender. Oh, I like this. This is so cute. Look at these. Thank you, Darren. These are awesome. Oh, this is from Wong Fu. Ooh, nice. I used to watch a lot of Wong Fu productions growing up. Wong Fu, thank you for the shirt. Hey, Elliot, you've been a huge inspiration, someone I've really looked up to on YouTube. Max, you legend. Max, thank you so much for the Perspectopia merch. This is sick. All right, one last package. Mail time. An air purifier. And, ooh, phone sterilizer. Thank you, Gaze, for the goodies. All right, that's it for my little mail time. I am very lucky that you guys send me stuff, whether it be stuff like this or even letters. So I really do appreciate it. It's pretty sick. All right, so it's raining really hard right now, and I decided to bust out the electric unicycle to see if I still remember how to ride this thing. I honestly have no idea if you're supposed to ride this thing in the rain or if it works in the rain, but I have to go pick up some textbooks and some school supplies, so I'm honestly kind of nervous. This is kind of sketch. If I can make it to the bookstore without falling, I'd say that's a big success. Actually, I'd love to make it back to my dorm without falling as well. Yeah, okay. Okay, I just had dinner, and actually, I also just took a shit, and you're probably like, Elliot, what the fuck, why are you telling me this? I'm about to put you on to this life hack that may very well change your life. This may be silly, but whenever I use the bathroom for an extended period of time, I bring a book with me to the bathroom. You know, I used to bring my phone to the bathroom, but at some point, like last semester, I started bringing books to the bathroom instead. And you know, you're sitting there, you're not really doing anything. You could scroll mindlessly through TikTok or through social media, but I always say this, your mind is kind of like your body. You have to work it out every single day to keep it healthy. It is important that you exercise your mind. For me, I feed it with knowledge.
Knowledge.
And in the form of books and reading, but whatever it may be, you know, challenge your mind, really get your mind to think about things. And you know, it's kind of like a workout. So that's my hack. I really recommend it. But speaking of working out, I'm gonna go work out now. I need my hype up music.
I thought a bro nigga said something. Talking shit, but they still ain't saying nothing. We gon' trap this bitch out till the feds come. Run it up, huh? What she say? I thought a pussy hoe said something.
Just got back from the gym.
Also took a shower.
While I was in the shower, I had a shower thought, and it kind of has to do with where I am now versus where I started as a freshman in college. When I first entered college as a little itty bitty freshman, I was reselling stuff on eBay. I was thinking about getting started with an Amazon business. During my sophomore year, my Amazon business failed. I had this much money in my bank account. That is 100% real. I didn't have any money, and actually I was in debt because I took out a loan for my business. So yeah, it was a bit of a rough time. Super, super stressed. I was stressed all the time, not about school, not about tests and stuff, which I probably was stressed about that too, but I was mostly stressed about the fact that I was in debt, that I had a failing business. And while all that was happening, that's actually when I started my YouTube channel. Coming into college, I thought I was gonna become this online seller making ton of money off Amazon and eBay. And then now that I'm thinking about where I am now, it's just like completely different from that idea of where I would be when I first entered college. And I think one of the things that I did right during my time in college was embracing change. I know a lot of you guys are young, not all of you guys, but a lot of you guys are young, and I'm super young as well. I think this idea of kind of tasting a lot of different things, trying to experience as much life as possible before really committing to certain things is super important. Here, I'll draw it out for you. I feel like I'm a teacher getting the whiteboard out. Okay, so imagine this is you. And these are all the different paths that you can take in life. And let's say early on in your life, you try this thing and you kind of like it. So you end up going down this path. And so a few years later, you're right over here. But in reality, your true passion is like somewhere over here. So, you know, this distance from here to here is, you know, pretty big, right? Now compare that to another scenario where instead of committing to this path right away, you kind of go around and test this out, and test this out, and test this out, and test this out, and you find out like you actually are more interested in this than you are in this. So you decide to go down this path because you've tried a bunch of stuff and you realize that out of the things you've tried, this is actually what you're truly passionate about and you enjoy this more. So you go down this path and you end up being close to your true passion. I don't know if this is really like the best example, but okay, I tried. I think when you're young, it's super important to try out a bunch of things and taste a lot of your options before you really go down one path, just completely convinced that that's the right path for you. It has a lot to do with being open-minded and really looking for those opportunities. So for example, because I had my eyes open while I was doing Amazon and while I was doing eBay, like I found YouTube as an opportunity. Even though like YouTube is going super well for me, I completely acknowledge that I still have a lot of life to experience. So I'm very open to the idea that, you know, even though I love making YouTube videos and I'm really passionate about it, you know, there might be something out there that I'm even more passionate about. And so I continue to try these side projects and continue to taste different things in order to build experience and, you know, just see if there's anything else out there that I really like to do. A lot has changed since I first entered college. Yeah, my whole life has changed in the past 2 years since I started YouTube. And yeah, the goal is to continue to try to improve my life and change it for the better even after college. So yeah, that is my shower thought of the day. It is 11:30 p.m. I have to edit a video, and then eventually I have to edit this one as well. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please drop a like. It helps a lot. And thank you for watching to the end. I am going to respond to a bunch of comments on this video. So if you have like a question or something, leave it down below. And I will see you guys in the next one. I like no blueberries in my ice cream cake. No edible with that masking tape.